Hello guys, welcome back to my video series Just Do IT.Career. Today we are going to see a few important concepts of networking that we are going to use again and again in our future lectures. So first of all, we are going to see what is virtual network, then what is virtual subnets, then what is IP addressing and what is private IP and public IP. Then we are going to see network security group and then network peering. What is virtual private network, that is VPN. Let's see what is virtual network. This is a definition, and further I'm going to elaborate on how exactly virtual network will work. So let us see the definition first. The Azure virtual network is a representation of your own network in the cloud. It is the logical isolation of Azure cloud dedicated to your subscription. Each virtual network you create has its own CIDR block, and if you want to link two or more virtual network with each other, you need to take care of that CIDR blocks that you are assigning to your network must not overlap. That is, it should be different. Further, we are going to see what is subnets. Subnet is also called as subnetwork. That is, we are going to divide a virtual network into different parts, which is called as subnet. So the logical subdivision of IP network is also called as subnet. The practice of dividing a network into two or more networks is called as subnetting. The computer that belongs to a subnet are addressed with a identical most significant bit group in its IP address. This diagram specifies that how the division occurs. Like, let's say if we have octet, which is a host identifier, we are going to divide that host identifier octet into two different parts. One will be used for host, one will be used as a network identity. We will see this practically how it works in our future lectures, but today I am going to show you how actually this division takes place in IP addressing part. So let's move ahead. Let us consider a virtual network is nothing but a society. In a society, there would be buildings. What if you want to divide your society into chunks of buildings, like building 1, building 2, and building 3? Let's consider if you want the communication medium to be used for building 1, building 2, and building 3 separately. Then you might be creating a WhatsApp group named as building 1 group, building 2 group, building 3 group. So what will happen? Building 1 group members cannot see what building 2 members and building 3 members are communicating with each other, right? So this is how we can differentiate with the actual networking part. Let us consider building 1 is subnet 1, building 2 is subnet 2, and building 3 is subnet 3 that we have divided in a single virtual network. So this works same as I have communicated earlier in the building scenario. So if we divide a virtual network into 3 subnets, subnet 1 will not be able to communicate to the people who are in subnet 2 and subnet 3. Now moving further, we are going to see what is IP addressing, right? So first of all, there is a question like, what is IP, right? Internet protocol. Internet protocol is a medium which is used for communication between two or more computer networks. IP address is a numeric label assigned to a device connected to computer network that uses internet protocol for communication. So there are two types of IP addresses, IP version 4 and IP version 6, which are represented by a dot in between the octets. So IP version 4 have 4 octets and IP version 6 have 6 octets, and that octets are separated by a dot in between them. Practically, we are going to see IP version 4 because it is mostly used for configuration of network. IP addresses are further classified into 5 classes, which are class A, class B, class C, and class D. Subnetting is further division of class full IP address range to class less IP address range. So if we have IP address which will be used for our network, previously it would be a class full IP address. Once the subnetting is done for that IP address range, then that address range will be called as class less IP address range. So below is the table which will help you understand how class A, class B, class C and class D, E IP addresses are divided. Class A IP address will have one octet, which is network identifier, and rest three octets will be considered as host identifiers. In class B IP address, first two octets will be considered as a network identifier and last two octets will be considered as host identifier. For class C IP address, first three octets will be considered as network identifier and last octet will be considered as host identifier. Class D IP address will be used for multicasting, and class E IP address is actually reserved for broadcasting and scientific studies. Further, let's see how the subnetting works. As I promised, we'll see how subnets are created. So for that, we'll see this diagram. Let us have one IP address range that we will provide to our network. So we are considering 192.168.0.0, which is a class C IP address. Now let us consider a scenario where we have an organization named as justdoit.career, and in our organization there are two departments. One is finance department and one is development department. Now I want that finance department should not be able to communicate anything to development department, and same for development department, nobody should communicate to finance department. That is that both departments should work like an individual network. This is our IP address. So let me convert this IP address to binary first. So see, this is our IP address that we'll be using for dividing it to two different subnets. This is a class C IP address. So class C IP address have three octets in a network bit and one octet in a host bit. In our scenario, we have to divide this particular IP address range into two separate parts. So how we can achieve this target is by taking one host bit and convert it into network bit. If we convert this bit into a network bit, this IP address will be a classless IP address. Currently, this is a class full IP address, and if I consider this bit to be converted into network, then it will look like this. When it is 1, it will create one IP address range, and when it is 0, it will create another IP address range. So now only this much of host bits will be used for distributing the IP address in our department. So finance department will have this range and development department will have this range. So this is how IP address and the subnet are divided and how it works. Going further, we'll see what is network security group. Network security group is a networking filter, can be considered as a firewall containing a list of security rules which allows or deny the network traffic to resources connected in Azure Virtual Network. These rules can manage both inbound and outbound traffic. Let us consider our old practical scenario which we have taken earlier, which is of a building and a society. But how anybody can enter to that building? There is no gate, no window, right? So if you construct a gate or a window, that would be a good idea for the people inside the building to communicate with the external world, right? So let us move ahead and consider it as a subnet. We have a subnet created in a virtual network, but what if I want the holes in their subnet to let the people inside that subnet to communicate with the external world, right? So I'm considering these holes as ports in the same subnets. We'll enable the ports for different scenarios and for different machines in the subnet. Let us consider subnet 3 have a Windows machine, subnet 2 have a Linux machine, and subnet 1 have a database server. So what all ports will be required for these machines to communicate with the external world are, as for subnet 1, as being a database subnet, 1433 is the port that we use for this communication of database should be open, and 3389 is not a considerable port that we will be using here. It doesn't make any sense to open that port, so we'll deny this port in future. For Linux machine, only 22 is the port which will be used for connecting to the server, like it's a port for SSH, and 3389 is again the RDP port which will not be used here, so we'll again deny this port. For the Windows machine, 3389 is must required port, which is RDP port, and port 80 is a HTTP port. So if it is a web server, it will require to be open, right? This is a practical scenario how the ports could be denied and allowed using the network security group. Further, we will see what is Azure VNet Peering. So VNet Peering is a mechanism that connects two virtual networks in a same region through Azure Backbone network. So it don't require any external device or external connection to be established. And another one is virtual private network. Virtual private network is a programming that create a safe encrypted connection over a less secured network, such as a public internet. A VPN works by using a shared public infrastructure while maintaining privacy through a security procedure and tunneling protocol. So the traffic which moves from one network to another network would be in an encrypted format by using the tunnel protocol. Let's check out the practical scenario for this. Let's say we have two virtual networks, virtual network 1 and virtual network 2. If we want the machines in virtual network 1, that is subnet 1, subnet 2, subnet 3, should have the communication with subnet 1 in virtual network 2. We want to establish a secure connection in between two virtual networks. So in Azure, there are two practical scenarios. If we consider virtual network 1 and virtual network 2, both are in a same region, let's say in India, then there is an option called as VPN peering, that is virtual network peering. We'll see the practical demo for this lecture in the networking part. And let us consider that both the virtual networks that we want to establish the connection are in two different regions. Let's say one is in India and one is in Canada. We'll be using VPN connection for different region or cross-platform connection. So this is the difference between VPN and VNet peering. I hope you have got a good understanding of what is fundamentals of networking. In the next lecture, we are going to see the practical demo of how the Azure Storage Account is created.